Hi, I'm Jacob Hooker. I'm a chemist at Massachusetts General Hospital, and I'm extremely excited to tell you about our publication in the JCI this month. We've developed an imaging technology that allows us to see, for the first time, neurons in the olfactory epithelium. We think this might provide a window into the brain to tell us about the brain's health and its response to disease and treatment. I'm excited to have worked with Mark Albers, a close collaborator, a neurologist, who will tell you a little bit about how we envision the technology being used in the future.
In this research in collaboration with Jacob Hooper, his laboratory has developed a novel radiotracer that has the potential to quantify olfactory neurons within the nose. This is particularly important to add precision to the measures of olfactory dysfunction, which may be important in the early diagnosis of Alzheimer's disease and traumatic brain injury, as well as Parkinson's disease.
The imaging agent that you'll read about in our article in this month's issue of the JCI is a chemical called GV157, or Neuroflux. Neuroflux is a unique molecule in that it binds to the olfactory sensory neurons in living animals and allows us to visualize the population of those neurons over the course of time.
There are numerous non-invasive imaging methods to image the olfactory pathways within the brain, but none of them are able to image olfactory neurons within the nose. Neuroflux fills this gap in the researcher's toolbox and hopefully will fill the toolbox for clinicians as well.
Hi, I'm Genevieve C, Bittner, lead author of this study, which I completed during my postdoctoral fellowship at Harvard Medical School. Neuroflux is an exciting new PET radiotracer that allows us to monitor both neuron generation and degeneration. This is a three-dimensional video of Neuroflux within the head of a rat after intravenous administration. The Neuroflux signal is highly localized within the nasal cavity, where it binds the olfactory sensory neurons, or OSNs. We quantified the OSN population across lifespan in rodents, where Neuroflux measured the generation and subsequent aging-associated neurodegeneration of the OSNs. With longitudinal imaging, Neuroflux offers a method to quantify the rates of neuron influx and efflux in individual animals. The OSNs are known to regenerate throughout life. This video shows the regeneration of OSNs over 9 weeks as monitored by Neuroflux. The OSN regrowth is indicated by the change in color from purple to blue to green and the increasing volume of the Neuroflux signal. Given the olfactory dysfunction associated with neurodegenerative diseases, we investigated the OSN population in a tauopathy model. In this model, we detected deficits in the OSN population at a young age, when tau pathology and neurodegeneration are limited. In nonhuman primate, Neuroflux maintains binding within the nasal cavity. The region of highest nasal uptake is the superior nasal cavity, where the OSNs are located. Our data indicate that Neuroflux is a tool for quantifying neuron generation and degeneration of the OSN population, and that Neuroflux has a human translational potential.
I still remember the day that Genevieve first walked into my office and showed me the data on Neuroflux. I thought of many possibilities related to our mouse research on neurodegenerative diseases. As we worked together, we started to dream of moving it into the clinic. And recently, we've been able to do that.
We hope Neuroflux can be applied to human imaging, where it may help in our understanding of olfactory dysfunction in neurological disease and may accelerate therapeutic development.